I'm gonna present to you Sebastian Jordan. He contributes to Nix packages occasionally, and he's the maintainer and code developer to pypi2nix. And in his day-to-day, he watches way too many cartoons. Give it up to Sebastian Jordan.
Good morning. I want to talk about pypi2nix and nixpkgs-python. The goal of this talk is basically to give you an overview about what these tools are doing, and also ask for help a little bit, but more on that later. What is PyPy to begin with? It's the official way to install Python packages, basically. Probably everybody who used Python software at one point said pip install package X, and that's how it was done until now. And we wanna basically change that to use Nix instead. There are a lot of packages on PyPy as of the day before yesterday. 120,000. We probably won't be able to support all of them, but shoot for the stars, right? Python packaging has some issues. I don't know if you've ever written a Python package, you probably know that you have to write the setup.py to make your Python code into a package. And this setup.py is just a Python script. So you can put any code in there, and a lot of people do that. Like if it's Windows, or I don't know, if certain check for certain C libraries and do something else if they are not there and stuff like that. So there's actually no way in general to get, for example, dependency information before you run the setup script. Pip gives some meta information about installed dependencies, when you installed or when you built a package. There's real metadata. Real, by the way, is a binary format of Python packages. And you can find some information about what was done, what was installed. And we will see later that we pass exactly that kind of information. And there's another problem there, because it's not a compiled language, there's no configure phase or anything. So if we want to build our Python environments, we also have to make sure that when we call our executable or import certain modules, that the linker path is correctly set. As I've already said, we pass the real metadata, and because it's not such a simple step as, for example, with, I don't know, Cabal to Nix, if anybody knows that property, or Node to Nix, we have to do a lot more, do a lot more stuff to get where we want. We do that in three stages. The first stage is basically just pip install. We build an environment where pip is available, and also your C dependencies that you need for installing your Python packages. And in this environment, which we create just with Nix shell, we run pip install. That's it. Stage two is there to extract the metadata from the wheel, like license or dependencies, author and that kind of stuff. And in stage two, we also calculate the checksums that we put in our to be generated Nix expression. That's stage two. And stage three is just generated Nix expression from that. Our Nix expression, or the Nix expression that we generate with pypi2nix, have two parts, or three parts maybe. Of course, we have the machinery in place to build Python packages with the tooling from Nix packages, but mostly it is just the generated expressions for downloading and building Python packages as you would find them in Nix packages, basically, because we use just build Python package from Nix packages. And there's an overrides part, which is similar to an overlay. It uses the overrides. First of all, the overrides are there to give the user the ability to insert like special information that pypi2nix couldn't find. For example, dependencies that pypi2nix wasn't able to pick up because they were not declared properly in the Python package, or special environment variables that should be set on build time. And we use the fixed point calculation similar to the overlays. And I will later show how this might look. This is just to give you, to show you this nothing special. Like, this is part of the generated package set for CFFI. And it just looks like you would expect it in Nix packages. This is an example for overrides. Fortunately, this is not an overlay, so we can do stuff like packages and Python there in the top. Because our self and super attributes in this case are only the Python packages and not Nix packages. But here, I mean, it's a little bit cut off, but you get the idea. We just override the derivation to remove some stuff that we don't want to have in our setup.py, for example, version pinnings, because we want to take care of that. But nothing special, I guess, if you've ever overridden any derivation. Now comes the fun part, the live demo. I prepared a makefile, and let's first look into that. Is this big enough to read? Most people, or people who work with Python, probably know about requirements.txt. But just to summarize, it's basically a format, like the requirements.txt file is usually there to specify what should go into, for example, the development environment as Python dependencies, or even in the production environment. And the format is you just list the packages, new line separated, basically. You can put more than just package names in there, also version pinnings, but we won't do that in this example. Or you could reference Git repositories. We also have to install pypi2nix. This part. And then we generate our Nix expression with pypi2nix. And this is basically the example invocation for this case. I will quickly go over the flags. Pypi2nix supports Python 2 and Python 3, and the first flag, like the -v3, just says, use Python 3. The minus R flag is similar to the pip minus R flag. It specifies the requirements txt file that should be used to generate the Nix expression. Dash E flag lets the user specify Nix packages that should be available at build time or at pip install time. And minus lowercase v is just verbose output. And yeah, let's do that. Nothing in here. And now we want to make our requirements.txt file, nothing special, just, this is everything in there. Now let's generate the requirements.nix file. This takes, 30 seconds or a minute because it has to compile some stuff. In this case, we built LXML, which is just like one of the more famous XML parsing libraries for Python. And I chose this example to demonstrate that we can handle C dependencies. And here you can see, we just run pip. I don't know, maybe we have to wait a little bit. Maybe, I don't know, has somebody questioned so far? Maybe we can do that in the meantime.
Can you reuse the override?
Sorry?
Can you reuse override the previous creation in this
package? I'm really sorry, I didn't get the first part.
The question was, can you reuse overrides?
If we can reuse overrides. Like that you created for a specific environment. Yes, there is a way to let's just show this. Result pypi2nix. There is a flag that lets you specify additional overrides. I don't know. On the screen, it's still there. So there is this --- overrides flag that lets you specify any override file that you previously created. You can even get your overrides file from URLs or Git repositories with the exact revision that is currently at master, or you can even specify in another revision. So there is a way to reuse overrides, and I will talk about that later a little bit.
So this LXML library also depends on libxml too, right? How can the generator find that dependency? Do you have to specify it manually, or?
That's a little bit a dirty secret of pypi2nix. When you specify, you need LXML, libxml2, and xslt. It will just be there for every Python package because we cannot. In general, get information about which package exactly uses the C dependency. So we just give it as a built input to all the Python packages in the whole set that we just generated.
The Python packages can be derived from
The Python dependencies are derived from the pip build output. I will continue now with the demo. We just generated the requirements.nix file. Like this screen, which is also connected to the computer, shows everything constantly. So I don't know. Here's the generated expression for LXML, and in the in this case, LXML has no Python dependencies, so in the propagated build inputs, it's empty, it's an empty list. And here is the dirty hack I mentioned earlier. The common build inputs are now libxml2 and xslt, and this would be true for all the Python packages that we would have put in there. And just to show that it works, let's make the interpreter this builds instantly because I previously tested it on this computer, so you have to believe me that Nix ran. let's quickly start up the Python interpreter and import LXML. Works. Let's go on with the presentation. So now you've seen what works. You've seen that we can generate Python environments and that we can use them, but there's a lot of stuff that doesn't work for now. And this is especially tests. And this is a big issue because we really have to support tests to make this a viable option, maybe to use in Nix packages. This is just necessary to, if you want to use this in production. We don't support multiple PyPI instances. So if you have a private PyPI server, you cannot use pypi2nix to selectively pull from official PyPI and your custom PyPI server. This is due to, at least to my knowledge, pip has no way of telling the user from where it got the packages. Of course, we could pass it from standard out, but yeah, we don't want to do that because it would break every time pip updates. We don't want to rely on the front end of pip to generate our Nix expressions. And if anybody wants to do that, feel free to contact Rock or me. How much time do I have? 10 minutes. Okay. I want to quickly talk about Nix packages Python. Yep. nixpkgs-python is a collection of Python packages that are generated with pypi2nix. And there is a GitHub repository called nixpkgs-python, which Rock owns. It's semi-automated self-updating. What that means, I will explain that later. It offers binary substitutions. Because we push build artifacts to the binary cache via SSH. And it also serves as a library for common overrides. Semi-automated self-updating sets of Python packages. Yeah, we automated this with Travis CI. There's basically a cron job running every night, which executes pypi2nix and generates expressions, which can be used by the user. And it commits its changes that it made because of a Python package update upstream or whatever to this repository back. There are multiple Python sets, yeah, like all the great stuff you know or use, but yeah, not by far everything. Like for example, Django, I think it's only Django. It's no plugins, no extensions by now, but we plan on expanding that. And they are organized in groups that make sense. Like, yeah, you would put, for example, PyTest with its extensions in one package set because you have to make sure that these work together, and this is how we organize it for now, especially to mitigate like really long build times. Different versions for Python 2 and 3. I mean, this won't be an issue for too long, but for now it is. It's a library of common overrides. That means like there are already predefined overrides that you can use, and PyPI offers a --default-overrides flag that pulls automatically the overrides from nixpkgs-python in your Nix expression. This is also like it depends on the revision of that was current when you executed this command. So if you generate Nix expression, it won't break in the future. Even if we update something that might break you, your old expressions would still work. This is not the default behavior, but it is planned to be the default behavior soon. What we want to do is, with nixpkgs-python, we want to provide an easy way to install your Python packages. And for that, we would like to use overlays, maybe like with a, like as intended. there is already an overlay definition in the repo, but that you could use. But yeah, as we saw yesterday, it still needs some overhauling. we could generate a static PyPI from our expression. That would be also really nice to help with, I don't know, generation of Docker images or whatever. Because if you have a PyPI repository with only the versions you really need for the job, you don't run into trouble with like version fuck-ups or whatever. To enable tests, we need to rework the Python infrastructure a little bit. If that's possible at least. There's currently no way to differentiate between build inputs for a package, like test inputs, especially like PyTest, and runtime inputs. From the way we generate our expressions, so we have to figure out something there. So now, I don't know. The future. We would very much like to use an automated tool in Nix packages to generate Python packages for basically end-user consumption, or I don't know, for packages that need these as dependencies, I don't know. But we definitely don't support this now. Don't expect us to integrate well with your Nix packages needs for now, because we are just not there yet. We would like to support that, but For the reasons I already explained, it's a little bit difficult. So what we could do instead is generate a set of overlays and offer that to Nix users. This would probably be like the least intrusive way to get people to know the tool and how it works. Building pull requests on Hydra would be nice, but that's probably what a lot of people think. Okay. That was my talk. Any questions?
We don't have much time.
Any question?
So there is a new tool called the pipenv by Kenneth Reeds, I think. So it's like it's using pip file instead of requirement.nix, requirement.txt, and it generates pip file.log, which have like like the dependency, the version, and the hash of the package. So does that make sense to be used in pypi2nix? It's officially recommended to be used by a Python organization.
Okay, thanks for the hint. We'll look into that. Actually, I didn't know about this pipenv command.
Yeah, pipenv, yeah.
Last question.
So I was just wondering, how do you select which packages to put into an nixpkgs-python? Or do you only build dependencies of these three packages?
The workflow until now was, I need some Python packages for my work, so I put it in nixpkgs-python. So it was basically derived from what I and Rock needed for our purposes until now. Like, so there is no formal specification on what goes into what kind of package set in nixpkgs-python. Until now, but we are open for proposals, of course.
Okay. Thank you. Just